basically you're all about human creativity. You're about films. We've already seen what your own AI, generative AI, being used within Everything Everywhere All at Once. How is it being used in a way that perhaps surprises you?
Many ways. We started to see things that were just literally impossible to do before now being made possible with these technologies. I think we're still very early to understand the full creative potential of everything that will come. But yeah, you have folks like Everything Everywhere All at Once using Runway to edit some scenes in there. You have musicians and artists taking like really the technology to the next level, which we think it's really the right thing to do, which is start experimenting and exploring more with these capacities.
You have, of course, all of this excitement, euphoria. There's also a lot of nerves, particularly around people who worry that their own art, their own imaging is being used to train AIs on. How are you squaring that circle? Because it's a difficult one to navigate.
Yeah, I know. And we've always thought about that in a very particular, interesting, different way. I come from an artistic background, and so I have deep empathy for those artists and those creatives who are asking themselves, what's going to happen next with this technology? I think a thing to remind ourselves is that we're still very early, and what we need to do is open the conversation to have more people come in and understand how you're going to start leveraging this technology in your art practice. I think that for me is really, really important and something we practice in Runway kind of like from the very beginning.
Cris, your Gen 2 system is still on a waitlist basis, right? I know a lot of folks that I've spoken to out this way are keen to get access, but the reality is, you know, text to video, it generates about 3 seconds. And I wondered how much you're emphasizing the kind of early stage that this is in. 3 seconds, not a lot of content to generate using the tool.
I agree, 3 seconds is not enough. We already have 15 second like long support on Gen 2, and we're working towards including and adding more to that. I think the reason we released with 3 seconds is really to make sure that more people can get their hands on the research, on the product, on this new way of creating content. And we already have thousands of people using it. And so the amount of feedback we've gotten to improve the quality of the model, the experience as well, I think text to video is one of many modes of using Gen 2. Actually has 8 different modes. Today we released the mobile app. For the first time ever, you can try Gen 1 actually on your iPhone. And so there's so many things yet to be explored and discovered here that for us really it's just making sure that we could put it in the hands of more creatives out there.
I was listening to Noam Shazir, the CEO of Character AI, on the No Priors podcast the other day, and he faces a similar debate, right? How do you onboard users and grow the user base and then in the future monetize? And I wonder how that equation looks for you as well, the focus on kind of making money or just growing the number of users and investing in the infrastructure needed to support it.
I think it's important that we remember that we're very early on the journey of both value capture and monetization industry-wide. And so making sure that you work with as many people and as many companies as you can will help you untap possible value captures. I think overall, what we're starting to see is just the initial stages of that. And for us, it's really making sure that we can keep building the research and the foundational effort to build better models and more safe models over time.
Hey, Caro, I think back to when Sonia Huang of Sequoia was on the show, a venture capitalist explaining why she sees potential here. You know, think about one's ability to dream up anything and use the generative tool to just create your own video. That's where the VCs seem to be wanting to put their money.
To augment humanity, not to cut against it at the moment. But Cris, I turn to you and think about how enthusiastic certain VCs have been around you. I think Akotu, Lux Capital, Felices. You've got a lot of money coming your direction. Are you turning it away? Are you thinking about raising funds opportunistically?
So we started Runway like 4 or 5 years ago. I've been working on generative models and creative tools for the last 8 years or so. When we started, it was hard. Generative AI wasn't really a thing, and people told us we were crazy. Like, generative AI was never going to be a thing.
Really? They did, as little as 4 years
ago? Yeah, 4 years ago, people were like, Cris, this is not a thing. Generative AI is not a market. And so the one thing that I think has changed now is I don't have to convince more people that this is worth paying attention to. That's for sure. But we're very fortunate to be able to work with investors that believed in that very early on, where perhaps there weren't as much proof points, and it's a long-term bet. But I go back to what I mentioned before. It's still very early, and a lot of what needs to be built around the industry at large is still yet to be built. And so there's a lot of opportunities for more investors to invest in more kind of like...
In you?
Can't really speak about like fundraising, but I think the industry at large will continue to grow very, very fast.